Michael J. Fox, a rare interview with one of Hollywood's biggest stars, who for 7 years kept one of its biggest secrets. He had Parkinson's disease. At first, he turned to drink. Then, with the love of his wife and children, he turned to finding a cure. Today, he's recognised as the one person on earth doing more than anyone else to beat this cruel condition. Just putting himself in front of our camera was a big effort, but as you'll learn, he's not without support. A young Australian dad has inspired him to keep going. It's the frankest, nothing off limits interview you'll ever see. Rani Sadler reports.
At the age of 29, at the height of his fame, Michael J. Fox was diagnosed with Parkinson's disease.
G'day, Michael.
G'day.
How are you?
Good, thank you.
I'm Rani.
Michael is now 50.
Please sit down.
He rarely gives interviews, and when he does, he takes medication beforehand to steady the shaking.
How are you feeling today? You all right?
He can never guarantee when it will kick in.
Ready to go now?
Yeah, here we go.
Yeah?
But we have Parkinson's. You deal with what we call on-offs. And when you're on, it's great, and like I'm on right now, and it's, I don't care what it looks like, but it's comfortable. I can sit and be still, and I can speak coherently, and I don't have cognitive, it just easily be off.
Really, it's an interesting mustache, and now nobody could wear it, you know. Oh, thanks. Oh, Jesus Christ! What the hell?
What?
Did you shake that up on purpose?
Parkinson's.
In recent years, Michael has embraced his Parkinson's in TV roles.
And it makes me do this and this and...
But the biggest challenge of his life is off-screen. It's his quest for a cure. And now the actor-turned-advocate has a new partner. Australian father of three, Clyde Campbell.
Am I going to be Clyde that's got Parkinson's, or am I going to be Clyde that does something about Parkinson's?
I wouldn't put it past an Aussie to figure it out.
G'day, Michael. Good to see you, mate.
Working together, their plan is to cure the disease.
He has no other agenda than to cure Parkinson's. That's all he wants to do is cure Parkinson's. And
we can all go home then.
And we can all go home. Yeah. Yeah.
All right, okay, let's fly. Get a grip on yourself. It's all a dream. It's just a very intense dream.
In the 80s and 90s, Michael was living a Hollywood dream, starring in some of the biggest movies and TV shows of the time.
Easy.
A Teen Wolf.
Easy.
And a teen pinup.
You really think you're hot stuff, huh, Alex?
Pretty hot, yeah.
His big break as Alex P. Keaton on Family Ties came in 1982, and it came in the nick of time.
Ah, right again. This is child's play.
By the time you got to Family Ties, you were really on skid row.
Yeah, I was broke. When I was negotiating the deal for it, my phone service was cut off, so I was using a payphone at a chicken, fast food chicken place in my neighborhood, and I was passing it off as my phone. It was like my office. And so I was on the phone negotiating this contract for, like, hundreds of thousands of dollars.
I'm from the future. I came here in a time machine that you invented. Now I need your help to get back to the year 1985.
In 1985, Michael was in such high demand, he was juggling jobs, shooting Family Ties during the day and Back to the Future at night. The blockbuster of the year was rewarded with a royal screening with Princess Diana.
I was right next to her, and which was really exciting and cool. Except that as soon as the movie started, I had to go to the bathroom. And it was instant and it was urgent. But they just got through all the rules with me that I couldn't speak to her unless she spoke to me first. And I couldn't stand up unless she stood up, having to pee the whole time. And so I just sat there for 2 hours. And so sitting with being at, like, on a date with the princess at the movies was destroyed by the fact that I just was, I was filling up. My eyes were getting watery.
By now, Michael was Hollywood royalty.
I had 5 cars, you know, it was crazy.
You were riding high, you were at the height of your fame. You thought basically that You were pretty damn good at that time.
Yeah, it was a charmed life. It was just a charmed life.
Alex P. Keaton, sophomore hospitality committee.
Congratulations.
It was around this time that Michael met actress Tracy Pollan on the set of Family Ties.
I am a very nice person, except when I'm around people like you.
She had a small part.
I happen to like people like me.
And he was the big star with the out-of-control ego.
We'd all gone separately for lunch and came back from lunch and we were doing a scene. And she literally walked in the door and the scene made an entrance. And I opened the door and she said her line to me. And I could smell garlic. So I just said, whoa, scampi for lunch, babe? And
you were being a bit of a smartass.
I was being a smartass. And this is what she said. She said, that was mean and rude and you're a complete total f***ing asshole. And I was like, wow. No one talked to me like that. And she was right. And I fell in love.
In 1988, they married. A year later, they had their first child, a boy called Sam.
Okay, Mr. Tidwell.
In 1991, Michael was shooting Doc Hollywood.
And it was during Doc Hollywood that you saw the first sign.
Yeah, my pinky started to twitch. My hand would shake, and I was developing these symptoms. And then I went to the neurologist, and he diagnosed me, and I was 29 years old. I didn't see it coming.
You were in denial, weren't you?
I thought it was BS. There's no way I could have Parkinson's.
You said, like with everything else, you were looking for an angle. You were looking for a way out.
Yeah, I thought it was negotiable. I call my agent. Can you get me out of this?
Yeah, this can't happen to me.
I'm going to have to screw to get off this picture.
Being diagnosed with Parkinson's at 29 is extremely rare. Most patients are over 50. Michael's first response was to drink heavily.
I struggled with it and tried to bury it in drinks at first because it was just so, I couldn't get my head around it.
You were heading in a bad direction.
You know, one day I just woke up on the couch, sun beating on my face and my son crawling on me and trying to wake me up. And I looked up at Tracy and she was not mad, she was not upset, she was just bored of it. And that was the scariest thing in the world. And I just knew I gotta change this now.
No one knows what triggers Parkinson's, but more than 80,000 Australians have it. Neurons in the brain are damaged and it causes tremors, loss of balance and impaired speech.
Does it feel symmetric when you do that?
No, this is a little slow.
For a long time, 7 years, Michael kept it secret. He continued to act, hiding the symptoms for as long as he could. At home, his family was growing, but his condition was worsening. Michael and Tracy have 4 children.
If you're that loved and you're that supported...
You gonna cry?
Michael's decision to go public in 1998 gave those suffering from the disease a powerful voice. He started a foundation bringing together the world's best research and providing funding for the most promising studies. In 12 years, it's raised $285 million.
We're full of smart people.
Michael has done more for Parkinson's than any other patient.
I just wanted to... couple things. My meds were kicking in about 10 minutes ago, and I was feeling great. And the bottom dropped out, so do something about that, will you? When you get famous, you have some lucky breaks, and all of a sudden it's all about you. And then you get a little bit older, and you have some experience. Well, it can be difficult trying experiences like Parkinson's or whatever. And you realize it's not all about you. And then it's so liberating.
There's a lot of pressure to do something correctly.
You want to talk about pressure? Try taking up golf in your 40s with Parkinson's.
See it happen.
It's important to find a golfing buddy with a sense of humor, like my friend Bill Murray.
Once Michael J. Fox sets a goal,
nice.
Nothing gets in his way.
It's just the excitement of where could this go next? Where could this ball go? More than anyone I've ever played with. Wow.
Your goal is to put your foundation out of business.
Yeah, we're in business to go out of business. Our bottom line is what can we do today? Who can we find today? Who's going to get us closer to what we're trying to get done?
Did you enjoy that today, girls?
Yeah.
What did you enjoy the most? saying Dad was crazy?
Saying Dad was crazy.
Clyde and Carolyn Campbell, kids Josh, Zoe and Phoebe, are new recruits to Michael's global search for a cure.
Who wants to have a little play in the water here? That's
Clyde is a self-made millionaire from Sydney. His Parkinson's symptoms surfaced 2 years ago.
60 of us in a meeting. I was about 2 minutes into the opening address as CEO for the company, and I started to shake. The papers I held in my hand started to tremble, which is really unusual for me. So half the brain saying, deliver the speech, tough it up, get through. The other half of the brain's going, what the hell's happening here? The hardest moment was telling the kids. Zoe spoke about it at a speech at the school 12 months later. She said, oh, whenever Dad calls us together as a team, there's normally something wrong.
He told us he had Parkinson's and I was very shocked, and the next day I asked him if that meant he was going to die, because I thought everybody with a disease died. But he said, no, it's just a disease that makes me shake.
Can I ask you, you are very optimistic, but are you a little bit frightened for the future?
There is an element. There's absolutely an element, but...
Sorry.
This is one of those moments.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm good.
Good.
So you didn't want to be a victim?
Well, I didn't want to be a sook about it. For myself, it was all about how to find a cure.
His search for the scientists closest to a cure led Clyde to New York City.
Will we all hang out down there?
And to a man with just as much drive and determination to solve the riddle of Parkinson's disease.
Hey, buddy.
Good to see you, mate.
Good to see you. How you doing?
Yeah, really well. Yeah, we were just...
Clyde and Michael are now working together on a groundbreaking study called PPMI.
We're really excited about having a presence in Australia.
Looking for the trigger that causes Parkinson's. That's the key to finding a cure.
Open and close the other hand for me.
It involves extensive medical tests on patients in the US, Europe and Australia.
It's the biggest research project the Fox Foundation have ever done. $45 million worth of funding internationally. And what it is, it's benchmarking Parkinson's so we understand the progression of Parkinson's disease. That doesn't sound that sexy, but it's incredibly valuable.
We just actually got an opportunity to come up this morning with one of our football teams.
So you find Clyde motivational?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, he could sit back and just... He can afford to live a private life and to not get involved and to just deal with himself and deal with his own issues. But Clyde's enthusiasm is and his purity of motive is contagious.
Nice to see you.
To find the cure for Parkinson's, we all have to work together.
You've got no doubt you're going to find a cure.
Oh, yeah, we're going to get it done because we're looking under every rock and up every tree.
We're in the future. Future, Marty, what do you mean? How can we be in the future?
I don't know how to tell you this, but you're in a time machine.
If you could go back in time, really, you wouldn't change the fact that you got Parkinson's, would you?
No, I wouldn't. I absolutely wouldn't. I mean, there's no... I wouldn't at all. Because this path that I'm on... is, like I said, it's so amazing.
Your nana told you were destined for greatness.
Yeah.
Do you think maybe this is what nana was referring to?
It may have been. It may have been. Because this certainly, you know, I always say I gave up my job to do my life's work. It's gonna be the best shot of the day.
Wow! It was the best shot of the day.
Optimist.
Nice.